Now, up to 9,400 youth and small-scale farmers are targeted to benefit from a five-year initiative of the Private Sector Foundation Uganda through Value Addition, a partnership between Private Sector Foundation Uganda and AgroCycle Global, a social enterprise, was launched in Luwero District today.
They used to buy for us 10 pineapples at only 1,000, but here, a kilo of dried pineapple, it is bought at 8,500.
Such is the delight of a farmer who used to fetch major earnings from her produce. Rehema Namubiru is one of the members of Sanyuka Women's Group in Luwero District, earning more from their produce through Value Addition. This after Grisako, an American Value Addition farm, opened its doors in Uganda in 2016.
Before I had joined Grisako, my mom used to work in the market, used to sell pineapples. Then when the lockdown came, mom stopped going to the market because all the markets were shut down. So we turned to digging. We had no hope again of getting money. We used just what we dig is what we eat. Sometimes even we had no sauce because we had no money to buy the sauce.
The farm has partnered with the Private Sector Foundation Uganda to create at least 34 groups through which farmers shall add value to their products. Through the partnership, farmers are linked to the market and helped to acquire equipment like hydrators used to extend the fruit's life cycle.
Standing here to see that they are the revolutionary district where we are starting this Value Addition, so that we have a complete value chain of producing pineapples, processing them and selling them at a good price. Getting the youth, especially at this moment when young chapati makers are busy misleading our girls, getting our girls into a program like this, which gives them money, gives them confidence, gives them authority over themselves and their bodies, it is fantastic.
Lack of adequate storage facilities in Uganda has severely been cited as one of the lead causes of major farmer earnings, especially during harvest seasons. A 2020 report by the Food and Agriculture Organization stated that food losses in sub-Saharan Africa add up to $4 billion annually, majority of this happening between harvest and the point of sale.
Thousands of metric tons a month from just a few different clients that we're working with. And we're very early in our company life as well. So we're a startup and we're growing. That means that our demand will continue to go like this. Our biggest issue right now is our supply. We cannot find enough microprocessors to work with us. So we've actually been forced to work with big processors to meet a lot of our demand right now as we try to find more people who want to make money every day drying fruits.
The partnership is funded by the MasterCard Foundation to a tune of 6 billion shillings. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.